Yo, what's going on, guys? What's happening, guys? I'm back. Well, I say I'm back. It's been a long time since I've done one of these videos. Probably over a year. Long story short, I wasn't in a good place. I'm getting in a better place. I'm here now. Anyway, guys, we're going to react to Dan Carter. He's an absolute fucking goat. Personally, I think he is the best of all time. Hence why the title, greatest of all time. So we're going to react to him, live up some good memories, hopefully, and just start off with a nice, easy react to warm me back into all this thing. So yeah, let's get into it. Mate, this Lions tour was absolutely fucking insane from him. I remember, like, watching it in 2005, and I was 2005, I must have been, I don't know. I wasn't very old in 2005, put it that way, but looking back at it now, it's like he had no right to do any of this. It's absolutely insane. I remember watching this kick live. I remember watching that exact kick live, and I turned to my dad. I just said, "Dad, what was that? It makes no sense." Like, just watch it again. It makes no sense, bruv. He's kicked out this corner flag. It makes no sense. How? It just makes no sense, like.
Goodness gracious.
He's kicked that fucking corner flag.
That's a boomerang. Stanley. Now the hands can't deal with Carter.
Gets Wales as well of all teams. Gets Wales. That's another thing. Like, don't get me wrong, the All Blacks, for the good 20, 30 odd years, they reigned. They had the reigns. They were very good, and it just seemed, every time they played Wales, they would just kick up another gear, for no reason at all. Like, there was no rivalry there. There was no animosity. It was just, I don't know how to explain it, but every time New Zealand played Wales, it just seemed they would just kick up another gear. And then when they, for example, in the Autumn Nations, for example, they played Wales first and they played England last, right? So I think England know what they're doing. England know what they're doing in the sense of, like, we'll play them last once they're tired, you know, sort of thing. And Wales play them when they're fighting fresh. It's so annoying. We haven't won for 60 odd years, man. Just give us a break.
Genius. Art trying to be the conduit. There's Rocafoco. The interception is there. Duquette. Carter after him. Duquette going for the corner.
What Carter in his racing days. Absolute fucking madman. But that the whole move there was insane. Everything timed so well. Yeah, I know he's kicked in the game because fucking Wales. He turned up. To be fair, he turned up in this game. This game he turned up, and then he wrote down his initials, signed the field, and said yep, and then left. He was fucking outstanding this day. Had absolutely no right to do what he did, and he just made the French look silly.
22, first time the All Blacks have really had an attacking option. Collins slips the pass to Carter. Carter's still going, and Dan Carter.
It's absolutely insane, like. His footballing ability is insane. Absolute pleasure to watch.
And a chance, maybe, no. Walker can't take
Carter.
It's Carter. He's got McAllister coasting with him. Carter, though, will not require.
When you think of Carter, you think ball handling skills, kicking ability, and maybe offloads. You don't really think of Carter for his sheer pace. Man had some pace, though. Man did have some pace. What? Look. I think he doesn't look as fast as Bowden Barrett. Bowden Barrett's literally 6 foot fucking four. And he's like, dang, I think Dan Carter might be 6 foot or maybe 5'11". I don't know. But maybe that's why he doesn't look as fast. But literally, he has some gas.
Putting coal on the fire.
That's the worst thing about it. The worst thing about it. Hold on. The worst thing about it is, like, you know it's coming. Like, you know it's coming. You can see it's coming. Like, you can see where Carter is. You can see where this guy's body angle. Look, he starts running. You know, you can see it's physically coming, and you can't do nothing about it. It's just brilliant to watch, like.
Is there to be a result? That may well be Carter stepping through. Carter scoring.
And that's, he does the inside dummy. Everyone falls for every single time, man.
Now Canterbury with Ellis.
Carter. Sheer centre of gravity is amazing.
Referee says yes.
Did you know there is a statistic in rugby? If you touch the ball at least twice in one play, so what I mean by that is scrum half passes me the ball, I'm the number 10. I then pass the ball on to the next person. If I get the ball again before they go into a ruck in touch, or the ball stops in any sort of way, there's like a 90% chance, or like maybe even higher, that you will score a try. And that's why scrum halves do what they do. They run with you on the inside line, because the likelihood is, if you get the ball back, you're gonna score. It pains me to say. I don't think Shane Williams wanted to tackle him. I fucking love Shane Williams. Rugby these days has just gone so structured, and just there's no fluidity in how people play and how people look. It's just, we have a game plan, we stick with the game plan, we don't know what we're doing, go back to the game plan. Like, sometimes just doing stupid shit is entertaining to watch anyway. And he got the ball again, and I guarantee he scored. His handoff ability is absolutely insane. A pleasure to see. Oh, and that's another thing. How could I forget his drop goals? When I said you should remember for a few things, how could I forget drop goals? I bet you're so smug living in New Zealand going, huh, we've got Dan Carter. Fuck off. What a time to be living in New Zealand, today. What a time. And also, to keep that level of skill into, like, I don't want to say old age, but old age for rugby, for example. Like, you see plenty of players, like, they get old and they don't really go much further than they used to. I don't want to name names because it's harsh, but if you know, you know. And he's just kept the skills all the way up until he fucking retired. He could probably come out of retirement now and still fucking play a 10 out of 10 game for New Zealand or even any club level. But if you look, any new 10 right now, he's not doing anything special. He's not doing like a goose step into like anything. He is just sheer center of gravity and using his his limbs to do all the work. He lets the ball do the work, and if he has to do the work, and then he puts his arms in the exact right position to be able to fend off anybody that comes towards him. He's not doing anything special. And that's what really a good rugby player does. Like, yes, some rugby players can do something special or spectacular, pull the cat out of the fucking bag, and it goes amazingly. But if you look at all the good rugby players, or I say even good number 10s, they all do the basics so well before they try anything else. That's all he did was dummy, and they all just ran across. He did nothing special again. But because New Zealand is such a threat, you have to cover, try and cover everybody. Just keep your legs driving and yeah. And then he came off after that drop goal. Bolden Barrett came on and scored that spectacular fucking try. Did he come off? I'm not sure. All I remember is Bolden Barrett scored a fucking try. And there's Bolden Barrett. Well, guys, if you enjoyed the reaction, if you enjoy seeing me back in fucking town, then put a comment down below. Just let you know, I will be reacting to not just rugby videos. I've come to terms with, last time, the reason why I stopped, I was like, well, I run out of videos to really react to, or I want to react to. I think I'm just going to react to anything that comes to mind. So I will react to rugby videos and maybe American football videos and all that sort of stuff. Probably like once, maybe twice a month, just to keep. Well, that's where my channel started. And if I find anything else I want to react to, I'll probably just react to that. But yeah, if you like it, subscribe. If you don't like it, subscribe. And if you want to do anything, just subscribe.